What is GMOs? Taking the gene from one organism, giving it to another one, and turning it on and making them genetically make what that person, organism made. Do you think medical people have messed with GMOs? Absolutely. We were working with genetically modified vaccines. Many of your genes, like 95%, are silent at any one time. Some should never turn on. It turned out the oncogenes. Onco is oncology. There are genes in us that make cancer, specifically leukemia, and they're silent. And so the medical people, we have a moratorium on this kind of thing. You will not do this until you know exactly what gene you turn on, where it goes in, that you can stop it if it goes haywire, or you can pull out the offensive part. There's no way we can do that in the foreseeable decades. So we got a moratorium on it. Are you told this? Are we getting informed consent for GMO food? And some of the vaccines we use, especially the live ones, they tend to drift over time to some strain which was maybe more harmful, and maybe we caused polio instead of prevented it. Now, you're dealing with a live form, genetic modification, and that gene they put in is not well behaved, it's not consistent, and might drift over time. We wonder, well, what can the average person do? In the past, I never, ever appealed to the average person. The regulators had a sense of integrity and what was right. Well, when the regulators are asleep at the wheel and I can't seem to move them, then we appeal to the public. Why was there no informed consent? That all the people affected, all the life forms, papaya is GMO, that's not intended. Where was the informed consent when you first came out? Not this hindsight stuff. Furthermore, everybody agrees each GMO is a case-by-case basis. GM tomato is different than GM potato. So all the new stuff you bring out, where's the informed consent? I'm really miffed at the FDA because their credibility was built on hard work. When I was there, we did good work. There was credibility which we deserved and we earned. They took that credibility and they said what about GMOs? Substantial equivalence. That, my friend, is an opinion. If you're going to say that, you need data. Bottom line is, where is the data? Where is the data? The FDA is supposed to be the source and interpreter of all the data. They do not have the data. The regulatory people were appalled 5 years ago at all the conflict of interest. And the lead agency, NIH, National Institutes of Health, said, you know what? When we're going to take on this conflict of interest, what is conflict of interest? There's bribery, nepotism, and on, the standard stuff. And between bribery and nepotism, political activity. The regulatory agencies are, the heads are appointed by politicians. The politicians are lobbied left and right. Just look at tobacco. The public could say, hey, look at all this harm. The tobacco guys lobby. Look at the jobs we give. Look at the jobs we give. So if that's the nature of how you change a regulatory agency, now that didn't used to be how it was, but if that's how it is, then it looks like we need public feedback to tell the politicians, fix the regulatory agency. GMOs, scientifically, until they make some great breakthrough, requires a whole lot of pesticides. You essentially have to sterilize the field of all weeds, fungi, microbes, I don't know. You got to do it. Why is that? You remember? Most of your genes, 98%, are silent at any one time. And when you need to turn them on, you turn them on. When you got to fight disease A, you make antibodies for disease A or B. You don't have it on all the time. GMOs is in a pretty crude stage. That gene you put in is on all the time. That's very tiring and taxing to the organism. And they get attacked by everything easy. You made it so they could fight the tough one and the easy ones pick it off. So you got to sterilize the field. You got to clean it all up. The amount of pesticides being put on in these fields, phenomenal. Technically, the industry should shut down just on the excessive, undocumented, unregulated addition combinations of pesticides. In fact, this is what, my fourth trip out here to Kauai, and we've asked them on the west side with the GM crops, what's with all the pesticides? I had no idea that we're using so many. We have no idea what the combinations are. And by the way, this comes from my background, drugs and vaccines. I can take two standard drugs, each one safe, and when I give them in combination, I have to go before the FDA because it was a new drug, both in safety and efficacy, to prove it otherwise. When you combine 10 chemicals, 50 chemicals, you have no idea. Now, in that first meeting, 3 or 4 years ago, there was a guy from EPA there, Environmental Protection Agency, and they do pesticides. But what he said is, each one of those combinations, it is a very low threshold, the threshold that causes harm, and then we drop it hundreds of fold just to put extra safety. Hundreds of folds of safety can be overwhelmed by tens of thousands of fold of potentiation by combination. That's just for two chemicals. You want to test all permutations of 70? Now, you got two choices. You can say, that's impossible. We'll never get that work done. Well, then I guess you don't do it. On the other hand, they will say, it's so impossible to do, we're going to say we don't have to do it. These guys are not getting informed consent. The task of looking at GMOs, let alone combination of pesticide, is daunting. And according from what we learned of malaria resistance, there's no turning back. In other words, you made a modification of a plant which was supposed to be weak and died, but you flooded it with Roundup, so only those survived. Well, if somebody said, oh, big mistake, take away the Roundup and the wild natural will return. That's what they call stable resistance. It's stabilized. There's no returning. Okay? So, call me alarmist, call me whatever you want, but then again, my only comment is, whatever you call me, show me the data.